Hello students, in my previous lecture I explained you what is the continuity and how we can find out for a given function that it is a continuous function or not. So now today we will try more questions or to check the continuity. Here in this series we are to check in this question number 7. Okay, what is the point of discontinuity? If this given function is discontinuous anywhere, then you are to find out that point of discontinuity. So if I visualize it on the number line, if I visualize this graph, function on the number line, then what are the critical points? Critical points are these points where this function is changing its behavior. It is given that this function is, when it is less than minus 3, it is mod x plus 3. When it is 3 equal to, equal to minus 3, per be the function is same. This is this. In between minus 3 and 3, it is minus 2x. At x is equal to 3, it is 6x plus 2. And for greater than 3, again it is 6x plus 2. Now if you want to check where this given function is discontinuous, for that we need to check its continuity from minus infinity to plus infinity. So we can see here this minus 3 and 3 are dividing this given real number line into 3 intervals. First is this interval, second is this interval, and third is this interval. So first of all, let us discuss the continuity of the function in these three given intervals. Then we will check the continuity of the function at these two points. These are the critical points, minus 3 and 3. So why it is called critical point? Because the function, the behavior of this function is changing in the left and right of this point. In the left of this minus 3, it is mod x plus 3, and to the right of minus 3, and this is the function is minus 2x. Similarly here, the function is changing its behavior at this point. To the left of 3, it is behaving in a different way, and to the right of this 3, is behaving in a different manner. So what I told you, first of all check the continuity of the function in these three given intervals. First of all check for this interval for x belonging to minus infinity to minus 3. We are not checking at 3, then we will take the open bracket. In this case you can see the function is mod x plus 3. You know, this is a constant function. Constant function is continuous everywhere because it is also a kind of polynomial. 3 can be written as 3x raised to power 0. So as we know, polynomial function is a continuous function. So this 3 is continuous. So I will always say it like this, that constant function is always continuous. And modulus function, I told you in my previous lecture that modulus function is always continuous for all real numbers. So this is also continuous, this is also continuous, and by the algebra of continuity, two continuous functions, sum of two continuous functions is also continuous function. So how to write this? We will write it like this. Since mod x is continuous for all x belongs to R, and 3 being constant is continuous, therefore fx being sum of, either you can write this or you can write this in this way also. You can write it like this. Suppose this is fx, you can write it gx plus hx. You can write it like this. So gx kya hai? Mod x. It is, we know mod function is continuous for all x belongs to R, and hx is equal to 3 constant function is continuous for all x belongs to R, and fx is equal to gx plus hx being sum of two continuous functions is continuous for, यहाँ पर हमें इसी इंटरवल की बात करनी है तो हम इसी इंटरवल में लिखेंगे. दिस इज व्हेन इट इज कॉन्टिन्यूस फॉर ऑल रियल नंबर्स, ऑब्वियसली इट इज कॉन्टिन्यूस इन दिस इंटरवल ऑल्सो. देयरफॉर फंक्शन, बिकॉज fx इट इज बीइंग सम ऑफ टू कॉन्टिन्यूस फंक्शन, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉन्टिन्यूस फॉर x बिलोंग्स टू माइनस थ्री टू माइनस थ्री. सो दिस इज नेम इट नंबर वन. Now come to second interval, that is, what is the second interval? That is minus 3 to 3. In this interval, it is equal to minus 2x. So here, you know, fx is equal to minus 2x. It is a polynomial function. Therefore, it is continuous for all x belongs to minus 3 to 3. Name it 2. Now, we will check for the next interval. X belongs to 3 to plus infinity. Sorry, this is plus infinity. Fx is equal to 6x plus 2. 6x is a polynomial function. This is a polynomial function. And this is constant function. And being the sum of two continuous, because polynomial function, constant function is again a polynomial function. This is a polynomial. 6x plus 2 is a polynomial. Therefore, being the sum of the two polynomial functions, it is a polynomial function. Therefore, 6x plus 2 is a polynomial function. Therefore, it is continuous for all x belongs to 3 to infinity. And students, we have checked in this way the continuity of the function in this and this in all these three intervals, and we found that function is continuous everywhere. Now we'll check the continuity at minus 3. At my x is equal to minus 3. Because you can see function is behaving in a different manner to the left and right of this at this point. So we will check the left hand limit, we will find out the right hand limit, and we will check the function at minus 3. So we will put the value here, minus 3 modulus plus 3 is equal to minus 3 modulus means 3 plus 3, that is equal to 6. Now come to the left hand limit x tends to minus 3 and fx is equal to left mein kya hai aapke paas, that is means limit x tends to minus 3, this is like this, and you can see here this is upon 1, this is determinant form, it is not an indeterminate form, so we can put the value of x directly. So it is minus 3 mod plus 3, that is equal to 6. Now come to the right hand limit. Right hand limit is to this side. This is function is limit x tends to minus 3. What is the function? Minus 2 into x. Because here again in the denominator it is 1. So we cannot get the indeterminate form. It is determinant form if we put the value. This minus 3, put the value and get the answer. This is minus 2 into minus 3, it is also 6. So we can see here f of minus 3 is equal to left hand limit is equal to right hand limit, that is equal to 6. Therefore, function is continuous at x is equal to minus 3 also. So we have already checked in these three intervals. Now in these three intervals we have already checked the continuity. we have checked the continuity at this point minus 3 also. So this is fourth point. Now at x is equal to 3, at x is equal to 3, now f of 3, what is f of 3? Function at 3, this is 6 into 3 plus 2, this is 20. Now left hand limit is limit x tends to 3 fx. 3 ke left mein kya hai function, we will write down that. What is that? Minus 2 into 3. You can see because upon mein yahan par it is minus 2x, upon here it is 1, it is not indeterminate form, that's why we are directly putting the value. This is minus 2 into 3, that is minus 6. And we can see here both of these are not equal, so there is no need further to find out the right hand limit. If you find out, okay, then see limit x tends to 3, fx is equal to limit x tends to 3, what is the function? 6x plus 3. And upon here 1, if you put the value, this is 2, sorry, so it will be 20. So you can see here both of these are equal, means f of 3 is equal to right hand limit, but right hand limit is not equal to left hand limit. This implies function is not continuous at x is equal to 3. So what we found from 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, we have seen function is continuous everywhere, but function is not continuous at x is equal to 3. So by 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, we can say function is discontinuous at x is equal to 3. Now students, I have taken question number 16 of exercise 5.1. In this question, now we are not to find the point of discontinuity. In this question it is written check the continuity, discuss the continuity of the function. We are to discuss the continuity of the function. So no particular point is given to us where we are to check the continuity of the function. It means if it is given that check the continuity, discuss the continuity, it means we are to check the continuity, discuss the continuity of the function for all real numbers. Means for this all real numbers. This is minus infinity to infinity. We are to check its continuity. What are the critical points? This is minus 1 and this is plus 1. And to the left of minus 1, it is minus 2. And on minus 1 is also minus 2. From minus 1 to 1, it is 2x. On equal to 1 also, it is 2x. And to the right of 1, it is 2. Now, again, as in the previous question, there were 3 intervals. In this question also, these 2 critical points have divided this real number line into 3 intervals. So, let us discuss the continuity in the first interval. What is that? X belongs to minus infinity to minus 1. Here, fx is equal to minus 2. It is a constant function which is continuous everywhere. It is a constant function. Therefore, it is continuous for all x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1. Because we know that this constant function is continuous for all real numbers. When it is continuous for all real numbers, obviously it will be continuous for this small interval also. Now come to this. When your x is in the second interval, that is from minus 1 to 1, then your function is equal to 2x. It is a polynomial function. Therefore, it is, and we know that polynomial function is also continuous for all real numbers. When it is continuous for all real numbers, obviously then it will be continuous for this small interval also. So it is continuous for all x belong to this small interval minus 1 to 1. This is number 2. Now come to the third interval. Again, that is a constant function, you can see, but we need to write here. So x belongs to the third interval 1 to infinity. Here function is equal to fx is equal to 2. It is a constant function. Therefore, it is continuous for all x belongs to 1 to infinity. This is number 3. So we have seen by 1, 2 and 3, the function is continuous in this interval also, in this interval also, in these intervals also. We need to check the continuity only at these two critical points. So first of all, check at x is equal to minus 2 if we check. So f, sorry, critical point is minus 1. So this is minus 1, f of minus 1. The value of function at minus 1, I have already written, that is minus 2. Now I am taking your left hand side, it is already given. This is already given. What is the left hand limit? It is already given. What is that? Minus 2, it is already given. Because it is a constant, no need to put the value of x, it is already given in the left side of minus 1, it is minus 2. And if we take right hand limit, limit x tends to minus 1, fx is equal to, here put the value, because it is x tends to minus 1, what is this 2x, because here upon 1 hai yahan par, indeterminate form is not possible, so put the value of x directly, so it is minus 2. You can see all these three are equal, so f of minus 1 is equal to left hand limit is equal to right hand limit. This implies function is continuous at x is equal to minus 1. This is your fourth point. So function is continuous here also. Function is continuous here, here and here in these three intervals, and function is continuous here also. Now we need to check the continuity at x is equal to 1. So at x is equal to 1. So now f of 1. What is f of 1? I know it is 2x. So 2 into 1, that is equal to 2. Now left hand limit. We know left hand limit. What is left hand limit? It is 2x. So left hand limit x tends to 1 ka left hai. This is limit x tends to 1 fx is equal to limit x tends to 1. What is the function? 2x. Because here it is upon 1. Put the value directly, 2 into 1, that is 2. Same hai ye bhi. So right hand limit, if we see limit x tends to, it is directly given in the right of this function, in the right of this, it is again 2. So we can see all these three are equal. So left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to f1. This implies function is continuous at x is equal to 1. So if we see, we have checked the continuity here also, and the function is continuous here also. So function is continuous on all the intervals as well as on these given critical points also. This function is continuous everywhere. So it means there is no point of discontinuity, but here in our question we are to answer in terms of continuity. So by 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, we can say function is, given function is continuous for all x belongs to real numbers. Sabhi real numbers ke liye ye continuous hai. Haan ji, students, in our last two questions we have checked the continuity of the function for all real numbers. But here in this particular question we are to check the continuity of the function at a particular point. ये एक पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट दिया है x is equal to 0, सिर्फ इसी पर चेक करनी है कॉन्टिन्यूटी और कहीं नहीं करनी है. तो सबसे पहले हम इसको विजुलाइज करते हैं नंबर लाइन पर. फ्रॉम माइनस इन्फिनिटी टू इन्फिनिटी क्रिटिकल पॉइंट इज 0 एंड एट x is equal to 0 द फंक्शन इज 0. बट व्हेन फंक्शन इज नॉट व्हेन द वैल्यू ऑफ x इज नॉट इक्वल टू 0 मीन्स टू द लेफ्ट एज वेल एज टू द राइट दिस फंक्शन इज सेम. This is e raised to power 1 upon x minus 1, e raised to power 1 upon x plus 1, e raised to power 1 upon x minus 1 upon e raised to power 1 upon x plus 1. This is okay. So on both sides now you can see the function is same, it is behaving in the same manner. So we can find out, means the left hand limit and right hand limit, whatever we are to find out, we can find out it directly. We can find out it directly that x tends to 0 fx is equal to limit x tends to 0, that is e raised to power 1 by x minus 1 upon e raised to power 1 by x plus 1. Students, if we put this value of the limit 0 here, then e raised to power 1 upon 0, it means e raised to power infinity, because 1 upon 0 becomes infinity, and this is, it becomes infinity. 1 upon 0, this is infinity minus 1, infinity plus 1. How do you calculate it? Not possible. So first of all, what I am going to do, I am going to do it like this. Limit x tends to 0. If you take out e raised to power 1 upon x common, then it would become 1. From here, 1 minus 1 upon e raised to power 1 upon x. Upon, this is again e raised to power 1 upon x. It is 1 plus 1 upon e raised to power 1 upon x. You might be thinking how it has come. Actually, it was e raised to power 1 upon x minus 1. So we can write it like this, e raised to power. If I want to take it a common, so I can write it like this. 1 can be written, this is 1 can be written 3 upon 3, 1 can be written 4 upon 4. So 1 can be written e raised to power 1 upon x upon e raised to power 1 upon x. If I take this common, e raised to power 1 upon x, so what would left here? 1 minus, this is common, so 1 upon e raised to power 1 upon x. I think it is clear to you now why, how it has come and how it has come. Now, students, now 1 upon, what is the value of, this is cancelled, okay, this is cancelled, 1 upon x. If we put the value of x 0, then it would become 1 upon 0, this is 1 upon e raised to power infinity, it is infinity, and 1 upon infinity we know that is 0, so it would become 0. So now if we put the value of this limit, then 1 minus 0 upon 1 plus 0, that is equal to 1. Okay, so limit jo aayi aapke paas, that is 1, but what is the value of the function at 0? But f 0 is equal to 0. So in this way we can see here, we can see left hand limit is equal to right hand limit, that is limit x tends to 0 f x ki jo bhi value aayi hai, that is not equal to f of 0, therefore function is not continuous at x is equal to 0.
And the students, you might be thinking that in this question I have not used left hand limit and right hand limit. If we are to apply that methods, then I am telling you how this question would be done by using that procedure, that method. So for that, first of all, f of 0 is 0. F of 0 is 0. So now left hand limit. Left hand limit may limit x tends to, x is tending to left of the 0, fx is equal to limit. Now h is tending to 0, and wherever is the function to the left, this is e raised to power 1 upon, wherever is x, we will replace it by 0 minus h. 0 minus h minus 1 upon e raised to power 1 upon 0 minus h plus 1. So it would become limit h tends to 0, this is e raised to power minus 1 by h minus 1, and this is e raised to power minus 1 by h plus 1. So it would become, if you write it like this, then it would be limit h tends to 0, 1 upon e raised to power 1 upon h minus 1, and e raised to power 1 upon e raised to power 1 upon h plus 1. As I explained you, if 1 upon e raised to power 1 upon h means e raised to power 1 upon 0, it means e raised to power infinity, means the infinity. 1 upon infinity is 0 minus 1, this is 0 plus 1, this is minus 1. This is all about the left hand limit. And if we go to the right hand limit, if we go to the right hand limit, if we
find out that then limit x tends to right of the limit is this is equal to limit x tends to 0. Right of side is this. So e raised to power 1 upon, now we will write down 0 plus h. 0 plus h minus 1, and this is again 0 plus h plus 1. So now otherwise I told you, if you put here value of the h, it will be infinity minus 1, infinity plus 1, that is not defined for you. So we can write it like this, limit h tends to 0, this is e raised to power 1 upon h is common, 1 minus 1 upon e raised to power 1 upon h, and e raised to power 1 upon h is common, 1 plus 1 upon this, 1 upon h. This is cancelled. So when you put the value of 0, h 0, so it is 1 minus, it will become 1 upon infinity, that is 0. This is 1 upon infinity, that is 0. 1 upon 1, this is 1. You can see left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. This is minus 1, this is plus 1. So left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. This implies function is not continuous at x is equal to 0. Our last question was an extra question that was not from the NCERT book. This question I have taken again from the NCERT book, that is question number 17. Students, in this question we have been already given the function is continuous at x is equal to 3, and we are to find out the relationship between this a and b. Now if I visualize it on the number line, this is 3, on the left side it is ax plus 1, and here at 3 again it is ax plus 1, to the right of 3 this is bx plus 3. So now it is given that function is continuous at x is equal to 3, it means left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to f3. So f of 3 is equal to a into 3 plus 1, that is 3a plus 1. Okay, so now left hand limit ke baad, f of 3 ke baad, we need to calculate your left hand limit. Limit x tends to 3 ke left mein agar aap function dekhte hain, iske limit jo hai aapki isme hi lagi thi aapki ax plus 1 mein, kyunki left mein yahi function hai. So limit x tends to 3 ke left mein agar aap function dekhte hain to ye hai aapka ax plus 1 upon mein 1 hai, you put the directly this limit 3a plus 1, both of these are equal, no problem, because if this question comes for 4 marks, then we need to find out this and this and the next one also. Then limit x tends to 3 plus fx is equal to 3 ke right mein agar aapne dekhna hai, to 3 ke right mein function is this only, yehi aapka function bx plus 3, aur isme upon mein 1 hai, so we can put this 3 directly. So this is into 3 plus 3. So this is 3b plus 3. So in this way, we have calculated all these 3. And now we will write down, since function is given continuous at x is equal to 3. This implies f of 3 is equal to left hand limit at x3 and right hand limit at x3. So this is 3a plus 1, this is also 3a plus 1, and this is 3b plus 1. So relation, if we want to find out the relationship between a and b, it means we will take these two. So this implies 3a plus 1 is equal to 3b plus 3. 3b plus 3. So this is 3a minus 3b is equal to 3 minus 1. This implies this is 3 common, a minus b is equal to 2. So this implies a minus b is equal to 2 by 3. So this implies a is equal to b plus 2 by 3. This is the required relationship between a and b. And students, tomorrow will, means in our next lecture, we will do more practice of more questions of this type.